Alright guys, just before this video starts, I'd like to let you all know that I will be streaming on twitch.tv as this video goes up or a few hours after it's released, so my Twitch link is in the description below. Come check out the stream. We're playing some Fortnite, having a great time. But anyway, I'll let you guys go on to the video. Enjoy. Alright, yo, what is up guys? It is Bazza here today, back with another Fortnite Battle Royale video for you guys today once again. As you can tell by the title today, we're going to be going over a little bit of a touchy subject inside of Fortnite Battle Royale. So basically, as you can tell by the title, we're going to be going over all the tier 100 skins or the final unlock skins for each and every battle pass throughout Fortnite's history, and we're going to be ranking those skins from worst to best. Examples of these skins, just to make sure everyone's on the same page, the John Wick and stuff like the Dire, basically the skins that are unlocked at the last tier for each battle pass. So we're going to be ranking those skins from worst to best, as I said, and I'm going to be honest with you guys, this is really tough to rank, and there's going to be a lot of you guys that just don't agree with my opinion, so probably expect you, I'd expect you guys not to agree with me, at least for the most part, because there's five skins, they're all great, and everyone's got different opinions, so definitely go ahead and leave your opinion down below and your top five, rank all these, I guess, from worst to best in the comments below. I'll read those, but anyway guys, starting off from the worst tier 100 skin, in my opinion guys, we have the Ragnarok. Now, it was so hard to rank, man, I'm gonna be honest with you guys, but I think the Ragnarok, personally, it's just not my favorite of skins. I just don't think it's that fantastic. Look, don't get me wrong, it looks amazing, but when it comes to these skins, it's not my favorite personally. I love his pickaxe, which is a really good thing about him. But I feel as if between the 5th stage and the 6th stage, there's just not much of a big difference when it comes to the style and the look of the skin. Like, you have the 5th stage where basically he gets the horns, and then the 6th stage he gets like the blue sort of mist that comes over it. And for me, that's sort of what makes him the worst one, just because of the leveling up stages aren't the best. The early ones are fantastic when he initially gets the body armor and the horns, but after that part, after he initially gets the horns, like, I don't feel like it improves that much, and as I said, in my opinion, this isn't my favorite skin, so it is here for the worst tier 100 skin, in my opinion. I know there's definitely going to be people that don't agree with me. I can see why, I understand, but it's just how it is, guys. So that is Ragnarok here. Moving on to the next one, guys. For this next skin, we have the John Wick, guys, as the tier 100 skin. So the John Wick is a classic, guys. This is nostalgic for me, because I remember this was the first battle pass that I actually went to 100 tiers. And this skin was super, super unique, and it was really different, because prior to this point, it was like, this character, he was just like, as weird as it sounds, like, he was just literally nothing special, no type of superhero, he's just a human, alright, that's literally what he looks like. Like, prior to this, we had the Dark Knight, you know, they're all sort of, characters, and, I don't know, I guess, heroes, if you will, but, like, John Wick is probably the most normal looking person inside the game, and that made it really unique, and then people threw on wings that made him look really, really aggressive and intimidating, and the John Wick is just a really cool character. He's super skinny, and also gives off that sort of, I reckon he looks pretty small in-game at least, so I like the John Wick. I used him so, so much in Season 3, and if you had this skin in Season 3, everyone was goddamn scared of you guys, but that is it for the John Wick. Moving on to the next one, guys. We have probably a skin that some of you guys might be surprised about. When I was making this video, I tried to come from a non-biased point of view. I wanted to sort of imagine this list in a few months' time and try to rank it from that sort of look at things. Because if I think right now, yeah, right now, to be honest with you guys, I want to get the Direwolf, right? The Direwolf is my favorite skin. But for this next one, guys, we have the Direwolf, or the werewolf, as I probably just said just then. But I wanted to sort of think of it this way, because obviously right now, the wolf is the skin I want the most. Everyone wants to get the tier 100 skin right now. No one cares about the other tier 100 skins, but I gone from a point of view where I can see myself liking this skin in a few months' time, and I feel as if it would fit right about in the middle here for the third best tier 100 skin, and yeah, I love him. He's really cool. The one thing that I was a little bit disappointed about this skin is that actually, after the second upgrade, it doesn't change at all. It's only the colors of the wolf that actually changes. So when it comes to progressive outfits, it's not the most progressive out of the other tier 100 skins, like the other ones that level up. So that's just one thing that sort of put him down on the list a little bit. All right, guys, so moving on to the second best tier 100 skin or final unlock skin for the battle pass, in my opinion, guys. This is the point where you guys are either about to get super angry at me, or some of you guys are just gonna disagree, because this is about to say it all. So anyway, guys, for the number two ranking battle pass skin, in my opinion, guys, we have the one, the only legendary Black Knight skin. All right, guys, let me explain why I feel as if this should be the second spot, because I know there's gonna be so many people right now like, Bazza, what the hell do you mean? Black Knight should be the number one spot. And honestly, these, the top two were the hardest to rank. Like, these final two skins were definitely the hardest, because so many people love these two skins, and there's great things about both of them. So let's start off, guys. Why have I put the Black Knight here? Personally, look, I really like this skin. And one of the factors that make me love it so, so much is the Black Shield. I absolutely love the Black Shield. I use it on so, so many skins. And I'm so thankful that the Black Knight came into the game for that reason. And not only is the shield great, the skin is fantastic as well. But there was one thing that, for me, just made the Black Knight not as good as number one spot. And that is the Black Knight without his own black bling, being the Black Shield. That is so many, that's a tongue twister there. But the Black Shield, obviously being the only tier 100 skin, or being the shield, being the only back bling that's come with the tier 100 skin. None of the other skins on this list come with a back bling, besides a Dire, arguably, but it is a part of his challenges. It doesn't actually come with the skin. But the Black Knight obviously comes with the Black Shield, and that is a part of him that is really, really unique and awesome, that so many people would love about this skin. And I have to agree, the Black Shield is amazing. But if you look at it this way, the skin by itself, in my opinion, without the Black Shield, just doesn't look that great. It sort of takes away from the character of it being a knight and that sort of warrior aspect. And I feel as if without the Black Shield, it's not the best, guys. And that is why, for the number one spot, we have the Omega, guys. In my opinion, I believe the Omega is the best tier 100 skin till this day. Two seasons later, I still feel as if it is the best, and I'm here to explain why. Personally, I think the skin is super aggressive, okay? So, so aggressive. Without a back bling or not, this skin is absolutely insane. It has the customizable levels and styles that you unlock through leveling it up with XP and levels, which is something that makes it a grind, and it progressively gets better and better. And not only that, you have the ability to change the lights and make it look however you like and customize it to the colors that you like best. And that, for me, is literally the points that makes this the best skin, in my opinion. It's super aggressive. You can change the colors. I love green. I can put green lights on this. That's what makes it awesome for me. So that is basically why I have the Omega for this number one spot, guys. I just love him the most. He looks aggressive. He looks like that villain type skin, and just looks super, super scary and awesome. So anyway, guys, there is all of the Battle Pass skins, or the tier 100 skins, ranked worst to best. Let me know if you agree with me or not. And make sure you guys go ahead and drop a like. I'd appreciate that, guys. And leave your lists down below. And if you didn't agree with me, tell me why. But I'm out, guys. Have a fantastic day. My name is Bean Bazza, and bye-bye.